allowing a hitman to kill both of their exes.
Enough of the stage, Roman.
November 9th, 4 days after the arrest, Valerie was released on a $50,000 bond. After a couple of days in the cooler, she says she needs to chill out and goes to see her friends.
Why would you want your husband killed?
She really did not talk about it at all. I think she knew that it was an uncomfortable situation for everyone.
We're trying to be upbeat and positive, like, it's going to be fine, we're going through this, you know, we'll help you out
for you.
But she seemed a little...
resigned.
A little defeated. The look in her eyes that I've never seen before.
A haunting look that becomes a final moment between friends.
And then in hindsight, I immediately realized she came here to say goodbye.
Just 2 days later, in a move that stuns those friends and the community, Valerie leaps to her death from her seventh floor balcony.
The death of a murder for hire suspect who jumped from her own condo balcony to death.
People fell to their knees crying. It was completely shocking.
I got the call, and I didn't believe it.
And in one final loving gesture to her friend Maggie, she pens this letter just before jumping to her death.
Can you read it?
Dear Maggie, I'm so very sorry for what I have done. And I'm just not strong enough to fight all the battles ahead. I'm tired and so scared and so weak. Be well and stay safe, all my love, Valerie.
Losing her career and reputation, I just think she just didn't want to live like that anymore. And mostly losing her daughter was the biggest thing.
It was just as much a shock to me as it was to everybody else around her.
Did you hold yourself responsible for her suicide?
No. That was a decision she made on her own.
So you never thought for a minute that maybe you'd put her in a position that she just couldn't handle and it drove her to commit suicide?
No. She had so much pressure on her, and I wasn't there to help support her.
Leon, who was never released on bond, asked the judge to allow him to attend Valerie's funeral, but his request was denied.
But Valerie McDaniel left a note detailing her final wishes before apparently jumping to her death from that condo.
She also left behind that audio diary she recorded, a suicide note in her own voice from beyond the grave.
I didn't wake up one day and just say, hey, I want to kill my ex-husband. It didn't surprisingly happen.
However it happened, prosecutors say there's no question Valerie wanted her ex-husband dead. It's actually